Now, hello and welcome. Next episode on Farming Simulator 19. On seasons, on console, on PS4. And let's check on everything. This field is fertilized. Two stages of fertilization. Yeah, missed a bit with the lime. This field is not ready for next fertilization. Yet. Yeah, it's only planted. It's not growing yet. So the seeds are not growing yet. It's only planted. So it's not ready for next fertilization. Right. Feeding animals. First of all, we need to feed all the hungry hippos. Boom. We are going to need this beast and something with no, you're ready for transporting. Yeah, we are going to do a lot of transporting jobs due to and definitely to change the tires on that bad boy. We've been using it for planting the trees, and the big heavy chunky tires, it did help a bit there. But now it's going to be awkward to go around and get the job done around the tight sheds with animals. So definitely need to change that, something more functioning. It's not very functional at the moment. Boom. Tires, different tires. Let's see. Of course, we have to. Within some mods, I noticed that you have to go again throughout all the settings. You have to go through them all again and reset again every time you go into the workshop with the vehicle. You have to redo them again if you want to change one thing. Yeah. Okay. Extra white tires, not necessarily, no. They're white tires, yeah. Still nice. Medium standard wheel weights. Alright, okay, that's the only options. We have Treborg. Standard wheel weights, white tires, and white tires. Chunky they are, alright. Extra white tires. Yeah, we upgraded the power in the Fiat. Extra white tires. Yeah, they look more. All right. Yeah. That will do. Should become stainless steel exhaust. Absolutely. We've upgraded the engine in that tractor, so there is now about 180 horsepower in that. 185, yeah. And did make a massive difference. Massive difference, really. this tractor used to be just around the yard tractor, but now it's going to be able to pull machinery around the fields and just help out with the fields as well, not just around the yard. The other less powerful tractors were stayed in the yard. Yeah, we need some trailer for feeding. And I think that this trailer is now in configuration for the flatbed, so we'll have to bring it to the shop here now and change it to a tipper for feeding cattle, for feeding animals. Yeah, it's a flatbed at the moment, but we can change that very quickly. Boom. Yeah, we have slight changes in our finances. We could say that we are slightly broke, although it does show that we've got 918,000 euros, but our total balance for today is nearly -2 million, so we didn't make any money today. As a matter of fact, we spent a lot. And also we took a loan of 1,420,000 there, but that's more about that later. We have to just focus on that and feed the animals. They're quite hungry from what the last time I was checking. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, everything is in within kind of yellow. Okay, cleanliness as well, so we'll have to clean some. They need cleanliness, they need water, they need straw, they need TMR. They need water, straw, and food. They need water. Food is fine, but cleanliness definitely. Need a bit of a touch there. Yeah, they need all of it again as well, water, straw, total administration. Cleanliness as well, okay. So, busy times. Let's get that trailer ready and take care of our animals. Boom. After one is that done, we will have to capacity 8,000. Yeah. No, that'll do. We don't have to pay. We have bought that option. We never bought that option. That's why we would have to pay for it. So, no, we don't need to pay and put ourselves into bigger debt. At the moment, we are quite broke and therefore we'll have to do a lot of transporting jobs there later on. It's 12 o'clock at the moment. Until the night, we pretty much, once we finish with the animals, we'll have to do transporting jobs up and down to make up the money for that budget, for that loan we had to take, for the money that we had to spend on certain investment. But More about it later on. We've invested a good chunk of money there to, and hopefully that's going to be smart investment to help out our transporting business and at the same time farm business. Actually, there was an opportunity of investment which involved expanding both farming and actually our transporting business. Our transporting business at the moment is going very well as well, but there is another opportunity came up, and I thought that would be good opportunity. It would be good investment, and it should return the money quite quickly. So hopefully it will work. We'll look at it later on, or possibly even tomorrow. Today I'm planning to be quite busy with transport and jobs in my transporting company. We need to make up for that balance there. As I said on previous videos, I am trying to finish each day with a positive balance, at least positive balance. It's not going to be easy this time. It's about 2 million euros to make up for. That's a lot, I have to say. We'll see. Now, since the last time we were feeding animals, we haven't gained any since the last transport. We still have the same amount of pigs. Still have 10 out of cows, 12 here in the large cattle pasture. That's the one with the milking parlor. Large pig enclosure, yeah, we had 40 pigs in there because we get... there's 4 breeds of pigs and we got 10 pigs of each breed of the pigs there. So it's 40 of them there. Sheep, yeah, the same. Four different kinds of breed of sheep. And we have 10 of each, so it's 40 sheep there. Another cattle pasture, the smaller one, that's the one for meat, more meaty breeds. We've got 10 Ayrshire cows. They are meaty cows, and 2 bulls of different breeds. That's part of experiment as well, to see what kind of breeds we will be getting in return. It would be interesting to see what kind of what the young calves, when they are born, what breed are they going to be, because we've got 1 breed of cows in that shed and 2 different breeds of bulls. Alright, same, it's the same way in the big pasture, large cattle pasture with the milking parlor. We've got Holstein cow, which is milk, purely milk cow, dairy cow. And we also have 2 bulls of different breed in there, and it would be very interesting what breed are going to be the new young calves. The new cattle, the young calves, what breed are they going to be when they're born? One worrying thing I don't understand yet, I didn't figure out yet. What's that about? Okay, thank you much, Kira. I'm just looking great, looking forward to seeing you. Your investment. Oh yeah, that could be interesting to some people. But more on that later. Yeah, I've noticed that all of my animals at the moment, they're not fertile, or they don't show any formation at all. For example, pigs, right? Next animal. Oh, hold on a second. We have a first fertile pig. First pig which is pregnant. There you go. Okay, so all it did needed a bit of a time, right? In 3 months here, in 3 months here, 3 months here, 3 months there. In 3 months, we are going to have a young piglets. Okay, in 3 months we're going to have a young first young piglets, and from then on, we will fatten them up. We'll fatten them up and sell them and make our first profit from our pigs. Because the pigs that we keep in here, we're going to keep for ourselves until the mature age, and then once they reach decent weight, they have enough, then we sell them, and so on and so forth. Am I correct? Is there two of them? 1, 2, 3. 3 pigs are pregnant now, and within 3 months they're going to have a little piglets. Great news. See, that's what I was looking at. Last couple of days I've been looking at the animals and they weren't showing any signs of reproduction, which started to worry me. Now, sheep, that's another problem. The problem with sheep is they are only females in there. And as far as I know, I didn't come across any male rams, basically, not sheep, but rams. I didn't come across any rams to buy. It'd be worth actually of checking it. Check that, but I actually don't know. This tractor is struggling with the grip without the rear weight. We're going to go there and grab the weight quickly, make the feeding process easier. Right, yeah, going back to the sheep. There's only females there, so it does not mean that now in the game with seasons we're not going to reproduce sheep, we're not going to have any young lambs, we're not going to be able to sell sheep as well as their product, which is wool. It would be interesting to see. Or am I missing something? If I'm missing something, you could mention in the comment. I would absolutely appreciate any help. That's my first time of playing. Yeah, this tractor is struggling for grip now. The back wheels are lifting off the ground. Now, problem fixed. There you go. And we are sorted. completely different story, different tractor, different machine to operate. Yeah, it makes difference, alright, yeah. It makes the difference. Yeah, that would be very interesting to see. There's millions and millions of theories and tests that we can do in here on this map. If you have any idea and any challenge, an idea that you would like me, us, to try to test on this map, write in the comments and we'll see what we can do about it. But I like... I'm not sure if that works on different maps, but on PGR ŚLIWNO, the feeding. If you noticed, all the animals, I feed all the animals within the same time, around the same time, right? So they go get hungry within roughly same time, same speed. But if you notice, sheep pasture, the food is full. So my suspicion is that on this map, maybe it works in different maps as well. Never checked that on any other map, but maybe it's a general thing for Farming Simulator 19. But it seems to me that if you drop bales into the feeding area, they literally help themselves with them bales, and you don't need to keep feeding them directly to the troughs. As long as the bales are pushed in the area where they can reach the hay, bales of hay, you can just leave the bales there, and the bales, they becoming smaller and smaller, eventually disappear as the sheep graze on them. Yeah, up here, over here, there you go, that's the sheep pasture, and I've threw them bales while ago. Now let's check with the lobster. Now this hay used to be 4,000 liters. Now this bale got only 3,449 liters, which means that sheep grazed about 551 liters off of that bale. Let's check on this one. 2,203 liters. There you go. So, 18,000 liters sheep grazed nearly 18,000 liters off of that bale. Okay, so as long as the bales are pushed here into this area, sheep help themselves, feed themselves with them bales, and every once in a while just have to check on it. If the bales are not here anymore, just bring a few more, throw it in here, and problem solved. A pretty low maintenance animal. Great. Since we are here, we may as well get rid of the lobster. May as well check on the types of sheep or breeds of sheep that are available to us. And just to confirm that I am correct, yeah, they're all females. We don't have any male sheep available to us to buy in the market. So does that mean that with seasons, you no longer are able to reproduce sheep and you only get paid per wool, from wool? That's the only profit from sheep now. Right. Okay. That would be interesting to see. If the sheep do get pregnant, it means that there is some kind of automatic system of automatic insemination of them sheep. There could be inseminated, and then we get little lambs anyway out of them. It would be interesting to see. That's another question, that's another test that we can go through. Gonna feed the cows first and take care of the feeding. Then we go all around all the animals and do water run, and at the end we're going to do straw run. How much do we have in that tractor there? Let's see. We've got nearly 3 tons. I reckon they could take more. We've bought way more cows now than the last time. We only had about 4 or 6 cows at the beginning, maybe 4 cows and or 5 cows and 1 bull, something like this. And then we made a good bit of money there on transporting jobs from our transporting company. So we invested and we bought all the pigs, all the sheep, and all the more cows to one pasture, and we bought more cows there to the next pasture as well, the one with the milking parlor. So we could expect milk sometime this year as well, this season before the winter. The only problem is that cows won't have milk. They won't produce milk until they have their first young ones. So actually, large cattle pasture, they all not fertile. And the problem, I reckon, is the bulls are too young yet for the reproduction. So we will have to wait until the bulls get older, fatten them up, make sure they're big, strong bulls. They're big, strong, like me, very strong, like a bull. Big, strong bulls. And then, hopefully, the cows will have their first young calves and will start getting milk. At the moment, we're getting no profit whatsoever from them cows. That's why we have to make sure that they will have their first young ones soon enough. Now, that trailer is full of food for cows. We'll do the cow run, the food for cows run now. Hopefully that should be enough. There's about 4 tons in it, if I remember correctly. Yeah, 4 tons exactly. Now, I always get confused with the big pasture. There is the two wings of them. They are pretty similar, pretty same. One of them is taking straw. Another side is taking food, and I'm always confused which one is which. But we'll chance it now. I think I should be right here. Yeah, looks like food because there's already mess around here. Oh, they quite low on the straw as well, on the bedding. We have to do bedding as well. Now, we need to tip on the left side, on the right side, sorry, and boom. Yeah, that's the food. How much are they going to take? Ooh! They took a good piece. They took nearly a ton up here. Hungry cows, right? Ton of TMR. TMR is a mixture of silage, hay, and straw. And mixture of the makes a nice feeding for cows. Okay, close that so they won't escape. Run away. And then we can come back out this way. Whoa! That's a strong gate, strong like a bull. And I'm stuck. But I will figure it out. Boom. And we are fine. Yeah, there is definitely more power in the tractor, but still you can tell that this tractor wasn't designed for massive weights and massive trailers. Every time you put something big on it, a big machine or big heavy trailer with heavy load, it struggles to stop, so brakes are still an old-fashioned one, so they're not as good, they don't work as well as in new modern tractors. Now, these cows need food too. In theory, they should take roughly pretty much the similar amount of food, since there is same amount of cows there and they were fed around the same time. But at the same time, we have to remember that these are meat cows and they should take much more food than the dairy cows. The dairy cows, maybe not much, but there should be a difference, so they might take more food. Oh, they took less. Okay, that's strange. I thought the dairy cows would be actually, maybe it's the other way around. Maybe dairy cows, because they grow and produce milk, they actually eat more than the meat cows. Could be that could be the problem. Alright, both cows fed, now let's feed the pigs. I really like the system with sheepies that... Sheepies, sorry, I call them that in my sheepies. Sheeps, sheep. The sheep. You don't have to feed them every day, same like the other animals. It's really interesting that you can just push the bales in there. I wonder would that work the same with cows, if you push the bales up there. At the same time with cows... Maybe that wouldn't be the best idea, because they need TMR for the 100% efficiency, especially milk cows. If they are fed only hay or only grass or only grass and hay without TMR, they will never get 100% productivity, which means they won't be producing milk as fast as they potentially could or would. So the bale maybe would work, but it wouldn't be the best solution for that animal. Now, we will get rid of that TMR out of the... We bought that trailer of TMR there a while ago, a big trail of TMR, the trailer that I'm using for transport. It was a huge trailer, and it's still here from then on. Ah, I forgot to tip it into the back, so create a mess. That's fine, we'll fix it. Now, pig food. Let's see. Pigs. Large pig enclosure. Estimate food required. 38,000 per year. Alright. Oh, it estimates the... Okay, that's cool. That's cool. It estimates how much food we're going to require for a year. So, that's actually very handy. It basing on that, we could just make enough silage for the year or enough bales for the year, basing on that. That's very helpful, very handy. But then we have to take into account the new animals as well. When they come in, they will require more food. We don't have any chicken yet, we don't have any horses yet. We need to, in order to get chicken, we have to purchase the land with the chicken coop. We don't have money to spend on bulbs at the moment, I'll tell you that way. On actual bulbs even. So no, we can't afford chicken coop at the moment. We won't be buying that now. At the moment we are broke, totally broke. As a matter of fact, I dipped into the money from transport and also took a loan from the bank, so I am planning on paying that loan as soon as possible, because I don't like the fees at the end of the season, at the end of the day. I'd like the fees for loan. It's just I think that's the money that I don't want to be spending. Pig food. And the bigger the loan, the more fees they charge you at the end of the accounting period. Also, if it's possible, if we could do enough transporting jobs today, I'd like to make up for the balance, not to have negative balance at the end of the day. That's going to require a lot of transporting jobs, a lot of work, but we can do it. Now, the investment we've made, I have to explain myself why the budget is so bad, why the balance is so bad. Basically, there was a land. I was driving across the map, was coming back from one of the transporting jobs, took the way around it, and drove by a field which appeared to have some kind of abandoned constructions on that land. So I was curious there, stopped for a few minutes, and it turns out that this field is for sale. And also that field had abandoned mine on that field. There was abandoned mine. Part of the land was abandoned mine. The problem was that we couldn't just buy the mine. It wasn't available to buy. We had to purchase as a whole land. Then when we bought the land, then we could start using the abandoned I will show you now on the map the best way to do it. I will show you on the map. It was field number 21. So it's a nice, decent size of the field. Definitely will use for some kind of crops. It's withered at the moment, so we will have to start plowing soon. And we'll sow it with something, something that only grows within warm season, because we have already early spring, fourth day of early spring, so the temperatures are getting better. Let's check the temperatures. That's economy temperatures. Here it's going up to 12-11 degrees Friday, Saturday 15-12 degrees, Sunday 16-11. Mean temperatures are not too bad either. We were still getting -1, -2 degrees the last couple of days. From now on, it's between 6 and 11 degrees, the minimum temperatures. Average temperatures are between 7 and 17 degrees, and maximum temperatures reach up to 23 degrees there Tuesday and Wednesday next week. Right, so we definitely could go with something that requires warmer temperature, such as... We have sown field with wheat, I think. Let's check. Also, I need to check if I have... Yeah, okay. So we have... Yeah, wheat on number 13, field number 13, which is a lot of wheat, lads. It's a big, big field. And there's going to be a lot of straw as well. We need to think about how to use that the best way. We're not definitely not ready to open the business of making pellets, which is great business and great money, but we're not ready for that. Requires few millions of euro of investment, which we're definitely not ready for it yet. We've spent too much lately money on the farm and transporting business that we have to just calm down for a while, gather more money, and then get into business, some business again. And we have canola. Canola. We have canola and wheat. So this field up there, we could use to plant or sow or plant canola. Is quite warm, that's why it's not growing yet. I'd say the temperatures didn't let the seeds to germinate. Cotton, oats. We could do soybeans over there. Soybeans are 6 degrees, they need the average 6 degrees. And we are getting average of 6 degrees in the next couple of days, so that should start growing nicely if we do that. In order to do that, we need to send the tractor there and start plowing that field, because definitely it's withered. Something is withered there. Someone didn't do work and didn't get the crops out of the field. The state, it needs lime. Okay, needs lime. We have to send the tractor there and start liming that field. We need something powerful enough. Fend, yeah. Fend could do that job, because we are using case at the moment for our transporting jobs. Actually... Yeah. Definitely we can do that with Fend. We've upgraded Fend to maximum horsepower as well, so it's what is it now? It's 185 horsepower now. 185, huh? No, sorry, it's 195 horsepower. 185, that's the Fiat. And also we upgraded engine in our case, Magnum 7250 Pro. And it's got now 261 horsepower. It's, yeah, it's doing well. That's definitely, we will need that machine for heavier jobs there around the farm. We definitely need the lime. We need to spread the lime there, and straight after we need to send some heavy tractor, heavy enough to do plowing with. The Fiat, the for forestry, our Fiat for forestry, that's 180 horsepower as well. Definitely should be the machine, that should be the machine for it. Okay, we have a sprayer here, and we first couple of episodes we've spent on gathering the resources for farm, Now, to be short, we've made loads of money on transporting jobs, and we spend that money on fertilizer, herbicide, for killing weeds, lime. Fertilizer, lime, herbicide, liquid fertilizer, and seeds. We load seeds, so we're not gonna be short lime. We're almost empty here. We have a nice silo here that we can refill. We fill that silo to the brim with everything that we need for next. Gonna be enough, I'd say, for next couple of seasons anyway. Since we don't have that many fields yet. Switch on the system and start filling with lime. Now we have 26 tons of lime over here. And you know what? Lime, it's not that fertilizer, you run out very quickly. So I'm not even sure if that would be enough in this. But sooner or later, no worries, we never going to have lime problems ever again. That's because of our investment, and I'll show you guys soon enough what I mean. Our lime problems are over, and also we're going to make decent money out of that, I have a feeling. Practically, technically, going back to the field, we bought the field. I keep interrupting myself. We bought the field number 21. We're going to take care of that field now. Also, part of this land is this dark patch over here, right? Part of this land. This is still part of the field, and when we bought the field, look, the green means that we own it, right? So part of this field is that area over here. So we own that land as well. Now, what we found over there, it's technically a gold mine. It's practically a gold mine. There is money in that field. We need to get out of it. To get out of this field money, which is right there, we just have to go and get it, literally. And I'll show you guys what I mean when we're up there. First of all, we have to lime it. It's a big field now, in fairness. We paid... How much did we pay? Well, technically 1.5 million euros we paid for that land. But then again, it took decent amount of money again at the same time to get that gold mine that I mentioned before already going there. There is old existing system which is abandoned over there, and we had to spend a good amount of money to get this going again. Now it's operating, it's operational again. It's operational again. We made it work, we made it happen. It's operational again, but we will have to just go in there with equipment and start getting that money out of that field. At the moment, we are too busy with that. We're taking care of the field and animals. We have to maintain that too in order to get the profit. Right. Field not owned. Yes, I am on the wrong field. Excuse me, I wanted to lime someone else's field. I do apologize. I didn't mean to do it. Definitely not for free, that's for sure. This field is a bit far. That's my cowsies. Moo cows. Moo. They're nice cows, but there's also a bull there. Strong like a bull. Like me. I'm strong like a bull. Right. Oh, bumpy. Oh, bumpy, bumpy. Oh. Coffee. Nothing better than fresh coffee. You need fresh coffee. At 12 o'clock, 12:30 to go to work. To wake you up a little bit, because it's middle of the night at the end of the day. Middle of the night at the end of the day. That is good. Good sentence, good saying. It's the middle of the night at the end of the day, isn't it? Oh wow, I can see right that getting into this field is going to be a struggle. So I can see why the transporting company gave up eventually, but I'm not going to give up. I will make it nice and smooth. Eventually, if the company is going to be successful enough, we might consider putting a tarmac in here actually on this road. Tarmac it all the way through from the... Now we are already seeing something up there. In between the trees, little structures. So them structures are old structures which were left and abandoned and left on that field. Now it took a good bit of money to get everything going and working, but siema Pajkiel, siema, ty znowu tu jesteś, wariacie? Wow, dzięki, że wpadłeś. Miło z twojej strony. Tak. Sorry, lads. I had a Polish-speaking language viewer, and not to be rude, I tried to respond within the original language to people who watch me in the who are Polish-speaking viewers. And I would respond to them in Polish. Sorry about that, but it's going to happen sometimes. Yeah, so that's the field we bought, right? And within this field, there is abandoned. There was abandoned here, not abandoned anymore because it belongs to us, but it was abandoned mine. Turns out it's a lime mine. Okay? So when we bought the field for 1.5 million euros, when I was coming across here, I was just driving around here, come back from the transporting job, I saw that abandoned structure there. The only problem was you cannot buy this field separately, this land, under the mine, where the mine is situated on. You can't buy this land separately. You have to buy the whole field, which we have done, but no harm, because at the same time we have few fields, one more field for our crops. It was 1,512,360 euros for the field. It came with that abandoned mine. Also, it took, trust me, it took good bit of money. As you can see, we've spent about 1.9 million of our own money. And we also took 1,420,000 of euros loan to get this mine going. But it's now fully operating. Also, you're not going to believe that. So this is selling station, and this is silo that you can load from the mine into the silo, and then trucks can collect the product here in the silo and sell it. So great news, good investment. It did cost, let's see, 1.9 and 1.4. So about 3.5 million. It did cost about 3.5 million, 3.3 million, 3.4 roughly million it did took, but it's great investment. Also, that mine's got loads of lime still left in the ground, which just waiting to be mined. It's a pure gold mine. It's a pure money-making mine. That's why this field was great investment. It's brilliant. It was brilliant investment. I have spent already money on it. Unfortunately, I know that I will have to spend further money again in order to mine that lime out of this mine. We'll have to get something like a digger or loader and start mining this lime. This is pure money. We'll get some of the money back for our field, and at the same time we'll end up with the field for our crops. Pure profit. But we did have to fork out quite good bit chunk of money for that. Now, this field came with that lime mine, with the silos, them two of them. I did have to spend good bit of money to get them going. They are fully working and operative. at the moment. We got this shed on this property as well. The shed, which is with the garage for maintaining and fixing equipment here. Yeah, let's close that door. We have a garage there for tractor or loader or something to store. We have shed as well. And what's in the shed? They left the trailer. They left a dump, big, beautiful, a massive dumper trailer inside, which I'm guessing was being used for shifting all the lime down there from down below here, from underground. That trailer was used to shift all that lime up to here silo, and trucks were taking that lime from the silo to the sell point, making monies, which I will be doing soon enough, as soon as I make enough money to buy some equipment for it. Let's see, what could we start with? Something cheap enough, because I am broke. Skid steer loaders. There you go, 5,900 euros. Actually, I think that would be one of the cheapest v options. Whereas available, as you can see, there are six within 60-90,000 euros range. That's I can't afford that at the moment. Wheel loaders, oh, that's within 200,000 range. No, definitely, that's a next step. It would be fast loading, be fast, efficient loading, but that's a next step. I can't afford that at the moment yet. Forklift wouldn't do much. Oh wow, okay, 90,000. That would be something we could go for. Yes, with that definitely, but not yet either. Front loaders, 60 grand. Yes, affordable soon enough, but not yet. Maybe we'll start then with 5,900 euros. If we start with that, I'd say that probably could do the job for the time being. Now this skid steer, the problem with it, I think we would find the problem with it would be too low of equipment machine to load big tipper trailer. So yeah, we bought the field, we got the lime mine on it. Now we did spend a lot of money on that lime mine to get it operative. It is operating now, it's fully functioning, my lime mine. And also we got this shed and a free trailer, tipper, dumper, which are going to be all we need, just something to load with and tractor to hook into it. We have plenty of tractors with plenty of power for that job. All we have to get now is something for loading. Although we could start with the tractor and the front loader, I'd say. Yeah, that is withered. What did they wither? When we bought that field, that was already here. They withered. They let the potatoes to rot and go to waste. Oh, wow. This is disgraceful. Wasting food like that. Potatoes. This is disgraceful. Wasting potatoes like that. It's not that you can just go there and pick them off the ground. Okay, wait a second, you can. Ho-hoo! Right, we're going to lime this field. And straight away after, we can. Yeah, there you go. Liming the field. Boom. Let's see the progress. Yeah, perfection. Oh, this is already fertilized. Interesting. Is that going to reset if I plow over this? I'd say it's going to, yeah. Needs plowing, does it? Doesn't say that needs plowing. But at the same time, I won't be able to sow anything on that field after the potatoes. I have to cultivate. Right. This beast would be perfect for cultivating. Absolutely perfect. It's an old tractor, but it's quite strong, I have to say. It's not very fast. Doesn't accelerate very well, but it's strong like a bull. So we'll send the tractor off to cultivating job. To be honest with you, for a field, big field like that, we nearly need two tractors to for cultivating. And we're going to send forced now. And then we're going to hook up a second tractor to the second cultivator. At the moment, that's the only way we can do it. The bigger cultivators require high power tractors, which are costly, and we can't afford it. Same story again, we can't afford it. We just can't afford things at the moment. We have to do it the way we have. We have plenty of tractors, plenty of machineries. Excuse me. And that should do for the time being. It does the job. It does the job. Eventually, we are going to switch to high power tractors and newer tractors. At the moment, this is what we have available. Okay, I am going the wrong direction. Wrong way. I think I... Yeah. This way. That's a, it's a good thing that we've upgraded the older Fiat to 185 horsepower. It's going to be plenty for cultivating. See the wheat already started growing. The seeds are responding to moisture in the ground and the temperatures. The moisture is very good. It has been raining, but it stopped, so now it's just ideal, just perfect for the seed, for the germination. Now the canola didn't respond yet, and it's in the soil nearly roughly the same amount of time as wheat. While wheat is already growing, canola didn't even start yet. But I reckon this is due to the temperatures. As you can see, the temperatures are now 6 degrees in the air and 2 degrees is the temperature of soil. Oh, that's the one of the warmest days since we started on seasons. So before, we still kept getting frost during, at night. Up to 2 degrees of frost at night, and that probably stopped the canola from growing. Oh, I'm gonna get caught on that rock. Rock, paper, scissors. Now, so that's the plans for the field at the moment. Cultivators, spread the lime over the fields to reduce the pH level in the soil. And then after that, we're going to put soybeans into it, which we hopefully going to turn into nice profit, and that will help to pay back the loan. Although, as the tractor's going to be working here, I'm going to finish feeding the animals. Once I'm finished feeding the animals, I'm going to just focus on transporting jobs to make the money back that we spend on that field. I don't regret that investment. I think I'm going to get my money back. It's just going to take a bit of a time first and a bit of an effort, and eventually I think we're going to get our money back. That was great investment. I'm glad I came across this road. To be honest with you, I got lost on the way back from transporting job. I got lost, and that's how I took this road. And when I passed, I'll show you the road I took. I was coming there from north. At the moment, I'm coming from east side of the village. I was coming back from north side and took this road coming in opposite direction. And when I came on this road, straight away I spotted them constructions, them silos, them buildings. And I was wondering what it is. Now, at first I was trying to buy this separately, just I was interested only in the mine. Turns out it's not possible. So I had to buy the old Field 21 for €1.5 million. Don't regret at all. I have a decent size of the field. He's getting confused here around the edge. I'll check on him in a minute. And at the same time, on the same soil, on the same land, we have the property here, which is abandoned old lime mine. He's empty anyway. Right. That's it for today. We're going to go back to all our work. If you want to know more about the lime mine, I'm going to start working in it next few episodes. Also, if you would like to know behind the scenes about that lime mine, I do invite you to watching video how to building lime mine on the map to get to know exactly how a lime mine being created in the land. Well, in theory, you find the ground with the potential for that source, and then just dig into it. This lime mine was an old one. We only took it over and got it going. Spent the money to make it operative again, make it functional, and it's functioning, fully functioning and working now for us, and we're going to turn it into profit. Anybody interested in how to make that lime? It's transferable to every map in Farming Simulator 19, whether on PC or console, and you can get it on your doesn't matter if it's a new map or map you already played on. It's transferable, the lime mine, or you can turn it into different mine. You can mine anything you want in it. So if you want to know how to get lime mine on your map, it works on every map on FS19. It works on console and PC. It works on PS4 and Xbox. If you want to know how to get the mine onto your map, just go to my video, how to build a lime mine, and I'm explaining everything there. If you would have any further questions regarding building a mine, comment below. I'll gather them, comments and questions, and I will do a video, instructive video on how to do things and try to answer all the questions, or if not all, then at least as many as possible on that video. Thank you very much and take care.